First, you have to know where the seeds are ripe. The different areas of the rice bed, they all don't ripen at once. So you have to know where to go to get the ripe seeds. And I know the rice bed, so I know where to go. I don't have to, it's not like I'm guessing, I know. And so I go out into the patch where the rice is ripe, and it is just like driving a tractor. I will drive in a straight line down to one end, and I go past the end of the rice bed, and that's where I turn my boat around in the open water. And then I'll come back right along that same line that I went on my last pass. I try to like make it right beside or maybe even overlap a little so I'm collecting the most amount of seeds that I can get in that pass. Now there's a lot of air turbulence comes off the prop and it's way wider than the boat. So I use that turbulence to blow seeds off the plants. So it's not like my boat is just a harvester, it's also a seeder. It's a joyful experience if everything's going okay, if the motor and the boat are working good and the weather conditions are good and the seeds are getting ripe. Menominee Anishinaabe is the word we use for wild rice. Translated, it means the good seed or gift from the Creator. It's been in our culture for a very long time. I was trying to feed my family traditionally by hunting and fishing and gathering, and wild rice was disappearing from when I can remember it being plentiful when I was young, and then as I became a teenager, I witnessed it disappearing. I learned how to turn those seeds into food about 35 years ago. I went to Ardoch, Ontario, to help them blockade a mechanical harvester from getting their wild rice. Harold Perry, an elder there, said that his grandmother brought the seeds from Rice Lake up to Ardoch, Ontario, and planted them, and they were using that for food. And so when they called out for us to go and help them save their rice from that machine, they taught us how to turn the seeds into food. And so I started going to those few places where the seeds were and planting them, where the elders told me that their camps used to be and where their rice used to grow. Pigeon Lake was my grandfather and his father's traditional trapping and hunting and gathering area, and the rice had been wiped out there. So I wanted to bring my family's wealth and health back. And so that's where I started. I started planting it right around here, right out in front of this place. I wanted it right close to the reserve so that people didn't have to drive cars or go long distances to get their food. It's a great part of our sovereignty. Without those seeds, we don't have sovereignty. That is the main source of our food. It kept us going in the hardest times. And so we need those seeds.